want to make sure everything's going good. GitHub. Confirm my identity. Configured. Oh, GitHub Universe. Let's see if you can hear me here. Looks like we're live. Get the chat out here. What's GitHub Universe? So we need to clean up some code today. Boom. GitHub Universe. Oh, what did they release? Code spaces. GitHub. GitHub Actions, Copilot. Wonder if Codespaces can run GPU code. Probably not. Codespaces, GitHub. Memory up to 64 gig, up to 32 cores. Wow. Siobhan, what's happening? Okay. So what we're gonna do now, we're gonna clean up Food Not Food app. Cause right now it's just a cluster of different scripts and whatnot. So we need to, what I figured is that it's a good idea for Nutrify to identify not food. So we're going to use this, if you want the repo, the repo's here, but we're going to really productionize this because if we can get Food Not Food working as a full stack application, that lays the foundation for Nutrify. So we've got a pull request here from Matanshu that makes it look much better. So I'm gonna merge that. Thank you for the updates. So we should have a better looking app in a second. Matanshu, I'm gonna pull the local changes. Git pull, clear. So if we go to Food Not Food app, refresh. Hey, looks a bit better now. Then we got the video on YouTube. Copy that link. Okay, so and I've got an idea to clean up more data. So let's go into here. So food, not food. Look at that. Let's test it out again. I need a photo of food. Mushrooms. Is this mushroom a food? Not food. The predicted probability can be fixed as well. So let's write down what we're going to do today. I want to open code. Let's go. Food, not food app. So clean up data download. Use open images for non-food images. You can also filter on open images for food images. Clean up GitHub Repo to make the app reproducible. Readme, turn notebooks into scripts. To do, make So here's what we're going to do. Food, not food app. And then, or actually we can add this into, did I have this the other day where I was streaming? 100k. Actually, let's put everything in from here. There we go. Oh, we forgot to add to here. Ray J.U., hello. Hey, Sadishwar. Paranjoy, if you want to run TensorFlow on your local machine, I'd go, here. I need to write an article about that, actually. Good reminder of me, for me. Write an article. So, here's one I use for Conda. Or otherwise. You could try this. Depends what machine you have. Otherwise, I'd also look up the TensorFlow documentation, but let's get into some coding. GitHub code spaces, we're gonna get rid of all of this. All of this. Let's now update the HTML a little bit. I want to clean up this because look how messy this is. Wow. It needs to be this. And then there was some CSS here. So look how messy this is. Let's start to clean this up. We want a directory for models. Now let's move everything TF Lightwise to models. We can also move it's going to break some things. Is there a move recursively? What's model.png? What's model.png? Okay, so we're cleaned up a fair bit already. Hey, this is not my README. I need to pull my own README. So that's going to break a few things. I'm just going to clean up this repo quickly, and then I'm going to merge to a different, that's what I should do, create a different branch. So if we go to script.js. To go There we go. Okay. We're starting to look a little bit better. Yo, Ashik, what's good? So I want to ignore any model that isn't TF light. We're going to celebrate 777 followers on Twitch that we're doing today. This is a 777 follower stream. So welcome to joining in. Welcome, welcome, welcome to joining in. That didn't really make sense. Okay, so now let's start cleaning up the notebooks. How did we download data? So this didn't actually help us. Let's make a branch. Okay, let's clean up these commits. Oh no, I don't want to do that. How do you git revert? Git undo. Holy crap, I wrote a lot of code during the 10 hours. I'm gonna stand up till I get bored. Okay, we should be a bit clean now. So let's start to go through this notebook. How did I download data? So Food Not Food is going to form the basis of Nutrify. So Food Not Food starts simple. So we downloaded images from we want to use Open Images Downloader. Open Images. Has Open Images had a... I believe I might have used you can download data sets. This seems cool. Homepage. We'll come back and check this out in a sec. We're going to clean up the repo first. But this is a fun thing to think about. Just how much time we spent on getting a... a data set ready. Okay, did we need this? I should save these to file. This didn't work. I ended up downloading images from random classes, didn't I? So we need Okay, this is good. Mitanshu, food image dataset. Where did you get this? This is beautiful. Name NutriTake. Wow. This is epic. Who is this? This is brilliant. Okay, will this be able to download? Beautiful. So that's going to be part of the next download when we make this a bit more robust. So let's clean up the data exploration code. What we really need from this is we don't need that. Maybe we should just start from scratch. I might do that. We just start rewriting the whole app. Okay, let's start rewriting the app. Okay, let's see if this downloads. Thank you, Matanshu. So all I'm going to do for this one is get food names from NLTK. Now, how do you remove I'll keep the underscore actually. Okay, lo-fi beats while coding. Where's a good place for lo-fi beats? So now we've got food list. Maybe I should strip punctuation as well. Sysop Dago, how are you? Yeah, that food data set looks like it's timed out. We'll cancel that. Wonder if we could make a Python list of the most popular foods. Oh. Food 5K on Kaggle, beautiful. Thank you. All right, we're getting some lo-fi, chill-fied beats here. Let me know if you can hear that. Okay, so we got some food list. Can you hear my voice fine if I just talk like this? Because I can't really hear myself properly. So if I just talk about this loud. Hush puppy. Beautiful. Okay. We'll just keep it on this then. So this is a simple script to get food names. What we might do is clean up these strings though. Reduce the background music a tad. Okay. I'm gonna turn down the background a little bit. Let me know how that goes. I just turned it down a little bit. So, list of food names. Thank you, Paranjoy. Hey, what app is this? Okay, so we're just gonna keep the one from NLTK. But I might filter out the punctuation and just have it as underscores or nothing. And replace everything with, see, pizza isn't even in there. So I'm looking to make this more robust of what we're doing to download a letter, a name of a whole bunch of food words. So let's go. Beautiful. So we've got a list of words here. So we're going to download this Word file and try out this function, because I don't like how we're downloading food names at the moment. Thank you. There we go, baby. We've got heaps of words. So we're going to get a list of all the words in a dictionary and then use NLTK to filter on those words to find out if the words are food or not. That makes sense to you? It makes sense to me. So let's now look up request. Okay, we can use try and assert for this. What we're going to do, we're going to write the code in. What does this mean? I love learning new things. Oh yes, team, look at that. Then if we try to run that again. Okay, so we've got a list of all the words. Now, thank you. Hey, why'd that stop? Am I still connected? Not sure why that stopped. Do I even need pandas for this? Thank you. There we go. There we go. List of random foods from the English dictionary. So that's good. Tables is a food, you're right. That could be fixed. Barbecues. So this could do with some more filtering, actually. So let's dive into the NLTK. I'll stand and work if you stand and work. I'm gonna go for a walk later. That'll be my standing for the day. WordNet as so, noun, adjective. Now, how did we get number four? These are pretty good. Iceberg is a food. Maybe iceberg lettuce. This function has an optional pause argument. So it gets the sysnet. Sysnet, okay. Okay. I see what's happening with this. It's actually quite a bit of a challenge, defining what's a food and what's not a food. So that's where we get tables from. Yeah, so I think this is a bit too deep. Like, it's going 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 levels deep. What if I only searched? Three deep, how does that change things? Let's see if the path similarity can help us out here. What is the numbering equal? What is the numbering? So we only want to, let's only search three deep, hey? I think that's a better idea. Do a similarity search. Yeah, there we go. Now let's compare. What if I was to only search 3D? That's what I might try. Zero is less similar, yeah. So we've just gone from if we change it to 3D, we get okay. About 200 less foods, which is good. I'd say we could even do this further by using similarity. What's hydromel? Okay, mead. Wonder what happens if we go reduce the depth to 2. Okay, I think that's better. We want it to be pretty. We can always add more, you know? So now we've got a fairly limited. We've reduced it by about 350. So that's good. So now these should really be pretty close to being foods. Locks, edible, drinks. Loblolly, tart, anise, snails, blackberries, sorbets, lychee, ricotta. There we go. Cacao nut, dressings, watermelons, scrapples, wraps, marmalade, spinach. Ricotta. Buffet, broiler, lobes, broilers, chorizo, calamari, do the banana check. Is a banana in the food list? Is apple in the food list? True. Is carrot or carrots? Oh, carrot isn't in there. Why didn't carrot make it? Let's have a look at carrot. Ah, it's the third one. What about mushroom? Mushroom's way down in five. Okay, so what do we think? Should we go larger? Ah, 2.5 here. Does the same thing work for carrot? Noun like artifact. That's a good idea. Where did you get noun.artifact? Because if I search here, you mean if there's something in here that's not related to food? If you have a link for noun.artifact, I'd love to know. This one. I think the path similarity might be our bet here. We could say that everything under two, to ignore. Because like, what if we go another word here, like, let's get some random samples. Trouts. Oh yeah, our artifact, I see what you mean, but they've got noun.food down here. There we go. So if we take this plate, how similar is plate to the food as a noun? So plate's pretty close. Because that would mean plate was in there then. Ah, because we've shortened the length. I get rid of that. I got an idea. What if we find all the words that are nouns that are food, but also have the verb eat associated with them? So I wonder how relatable banana is. That doesn't really help. What if I got rid of this? Find verbs. That's a great answer. So I want to find out if a noun is related to a verb. Let's figure out how to do that, hey? Okay. What about food? The score is, by default, there is now a fake root node. Yo, True Face, what's going on? Very deep in WordNet. Okay, so we've got a question. Thank you, Siobhan. We're going to answer this question and then we're going to move on from WordNet for the time being. So the question is here from TrueFace. Hey Daniel, I have a question for you. I have a bachelor degree in computing and electrical engineering. Now doing my master's degree experimenting with artificial neural networks and CNN. Since I didn't learn anything about ML, I have read some books alone and done your courses. Now it's time to look for a job. Do you think I can say I have enough knowledge to start working as an ML engineer? A lot of job applications I like about pose estimation and I'm weak there. Well, yes, I would say you have the foundations, but if you said you are interested in pose estimation and you're weak there, I would say, look, now you've got something that you can improve on, right? My best piece of advice for this sort of thing is start the job before you have it. So if you're interested in pose estimation, work on a pose estimation project for the next 6 weeks and figure out all there is to know about pose estimation. Right now I want to build a computer vision model that can take photo of any food and tell you what type of food it is. I want to start off by building food or not food. So I'm figuring out how to do that and uploading the code to GitHub. So if you want to do that for pose estimation, you can do this for anything. Find a project, whatever it is, or just follow something that you're interested in and work on that for the next 6 weeks straight. Upload it to GitHub, write a blog post about it. Now all of a sudden, you know about pose estimation. Post online about it, share what you've been learning, find all the best resources, put them in the GitHub repo, put them in the blog post. Start the job before you have it. That's how you best learn. You're gonna find out so much more by actually trying to build something. Look, I didn't even know about WordNet before just now, before this stream. And what are we, 2.5 hours in? And I know a fair bit about how to use WordNet to find words that are foods and not foods. And I want to do it by code. I could do it by hand. I want to do it by code so that it can scale up easier. So, yes, you've got the foundations ready for a job, but I'd like to see something more specific on what you'd like to be doing as an ML engineer. So, if you're interested in pose estimation, build a project on pose estimation, get your skills up, and then go and start applying to jobs that involve pose estimation, and then you can say, hey, look what I've done here, and then just link them your project. Okay, now let's complicate this a little bit much. There is always so much to learn. Yes, you're so right. That's why you're watching me just sit here for hours trying to understand like how to make a list of foods and not foods. I have an idea though. I think I'll be able to go to I have a better idea. I think I just worked it out. Puran Joy, yes, you can share it. Is it on GitHub? If you have code, share it on GitHub or Pastebin or something, wherever. Yeah, you can share it wherever you want. You can add it to the GitHub issues if you like, on Food Not Food. Let me know. Add it to GitHub or a gist or something like that. Okay, I'm just going to go with the original one. We might want to look up all the derivationally related nouns to, or verbs to a noun. Thank you. You made an issue? Thank you. I'll check that out in a second. There we go. Okay, so we've got an issue here from Paranjoy. If you want to add, we can turn this into code like this. I'll show you for next time. Thank you for this, by the way. Beautiful. Okay. Thank you, Paran. I see. This is very good, thank you. Excellent. Thank you, my friend. I like this. Yeah, see, torpedoes is there. So let's read through this code. F equals zero, fx equals zero, forbidden. If food not in, I like this. I think we can simplify this. Let's try and simplify this together, hey? Thank you. If so if the syntax name is in the forbidden break, which is similar to what you've got here, no, that doesn't make sense, does it? Let's go back to what we had. So you're right, we need a way to keep state. Yes, you're right. Thank you, Paranjoy. I appreciate your help. There we go. I think we've got a better way to do it. I'm gonna add this to here. There we go. Okay, now let's see how this changes everything that we've done. So we can get rid of this, get rid of this. How many foods are there? 2,068. Beautiful. Let's randomly sample. What's a gigot? This is what you get. Look at this. Google, I search for gigots, and it gives me this. Plunging neck gigot. A gigot must be a type of top as well. When really, I wanted lamb roast. You get ads for dresses, but it's actually a lamb leg. Search engines, am I right? Okay, this is good. We have a much better way of finding foods now. Thank you. Thank you to Paran Joy. Really appreciate that for your help. Now, if I restart this notebook, it works. Beautiful. Now we've got a list of food and not foods. So now we can do a little bit more cleanup. So we've got a list of food names from NLTK. So what should be next on the cleanup list? Cleanup data download. Yeah, we should do that. Cleanup data download, another data set for food and non-food images. Kagua Zabi, how are you? Good to see you. Welcome to the stream. We're building foodnotfood.app. Well, we're cleaning it up. We've actually built it, but now we're going to clean it up. So that's what we should do next. What do you mean by logic programming? If you mean logic as in if and else statements? We're going to use open images for non-food images. And oh, I'm only familiar with OOP and functional programming. Thank you for the stream, my friend. Thank you for the nice words. Which days do I stream? Usually any day between Monday and Friday, sometimes Saturday. Okay, I think that's what we're going to do the next stream. Let's find out how to merge from the command line. Husnain, how are you? Oh, you're doing the TensorFlow course? Nice, my friend. How are you liking it? Beautiful. We're going to keep making this code more, this code better. In the next stream. Oh, thank you, Husnain. I'm glad you're liking it. Thank you. There we go. Code's updated. I'm going to come back to this tomorrow. So thank you all so much for tuning in. We had some lo-fi beats. We've been going for the last 3 hours or 3.5 hours. That was a good stream. But the Food Not Food app is going to be continually updated. We're going to turn this into a full stack machine learning app. And then we're going to bridge a lot of the stuff that's coming from here, from Food Not Food, into Nutrify. So, oh wow, everything just got a bit louder. So if you want to stay tuned for that, I'll see you in the next stream. Wherever you are in the world, have a good night, have a good morning, and catch you next time.